I'm better at cooking than I am at driving, but it doesn't matter because I still have a long way to go looking for the most delightful organic ingredients that California farmers have to offer. I know living a simple hippie trailer life sounds so romantic, but trust me, it's only worth it if you can eat cake. And guess what we'll be cooking today? Carrot cake! But first of all, let's pick carrots. Alive and well. Today I parked my trailer at Apple Creek Ranch in Lompoc to check out their rainbow of different colored carrots planted one by one by Andrew Gibson. And it's these colorful beauties that are going to be the main ingredient for my carrot cake with homemade cream cheese frosting. Vegetables grow in the ground, so they run a high risk of being exposed to soil contaminants if they're not organic. Everything that you spray into a plant ends up absorbed by the earth. Heavy metals from chemical pesticides and fertilizers will end up in your carrots no matter what their color. Apple Creek Ranch is a 45 acres organic farm, and no, they don't plant apples. This ranch was founded in 1914, and it gives me very strong Tuscany vibes. Look at this. Tuscany, is that you? Here at the Apple Creek Ranch, they plant strawberries, grapes, but the star are the carrots. Every carrot is planted one by one to ensure a crop that's varied in color, nutrients, and flavors. If diversity is found everywhere in human culture, why not also in our fields and our baking? And these colors aren't just for decorating the garden either. Really? They ensure that diversity is maintained within the species. And by eating different varieties of carrots, we can also contribute to ensuring that this diversity continues. Everyone wins. Diversity will encourage crop rotation that is key for the health of the land. In case I haven't convinced you of that yet, Andrew will, because he's nicer than I am.
Crop rotation for organic farming is extremely important just because each crop will actually use different minerals, different resources from the land. So if you keep taxing that same mineral or that same resource again and again, you're going to get an imbalance. And if you get an imbalance, then you start to have problems. And so it's all of these things working together to kind of create that full circle environment.
That's why we need consumers to consume everything we plant, right?
That's right.
So tell them the importance of having a diverse diet.
Extremely important to have a diverse diet, and it's also extremely important to have seasonal things. You're not always meant to have tomatoes 100% of the time. The kales are just as important.
I'll probably use this one in my cake as well. I want to use
irregular.
All of them. Ah, that's so cute! Do you photograph like funky vegetables?
Occasionally. We eat some wild things.
Cool. This is beautiful. Thank you so much for all this work.
Absolutely.
You're like feeding people. That can't be more special
than
trying.
That. It's definitely not a clean job.
No, I don't mind. I like dirt. I like to be, you know, it's like my thing.
Ah, Heisa, don't play the farmer. When I buy carrots from Maple Creek Ranch, they have a face of Andrew Gibson. And my investment helps Andrew buy an armband. Why would he buy that? Ha, so he looks cooler picking carrots in this California corner. Please support your local farmer.
That's awesome, I like it.
I'm bringing a bunch of colored carrots with me, and when you mix all colors, you know what you get? Brown. So disappointing, isn't it? But that's gonna be the color of our cake. Listen to the wind of my soul. Now that I have my ingredients fresh out of the ground, I'm ready to make my carrot cake. Well, I think only God really knows. And we don't need any fancy utensils to make good desserts. That's the magic of living in the 60s. No more excuses now. So let's get cooking. To make the cake, in a bowl add flour, salt, baking soda, and baking powder. But why both? Because baking powder does most of the leavening, and the baking soda is added to neutralize the acids in the recipe, creating a very tender cake. Now we can add the spices. Pink peppercorn, ginger, cinnamon, and nutmeg. Peppercorn is optional. Mix it and reserve. In a separate bowl, add room temperature butter, light brown sugar, and regular sugar. With your strong biceps, whisk it until fluffy. Nice. Time for the eggs. In nature, color means diversity, and diversity is also something I look for in my eggs. Different chicken breeds means different color shells. I encourage diversity because that's what makes nature so special. Never crack your eggs in the bowl. Add 2 eggs to the butter mixture and whisk it until creamy and incorporated. Now it's time to add pecans, milk, always whole, and vanilla extract. I should have added the milk first. Now it's just missing one ingredient to make this cake rabbit approved. Carrots. Carrots have a thin skin full of nutrients, and if they're organic, there's no need to peel them. A good wash is all you need. Carrots are ready to be shredded, and a serrated knife is all you need to get things done. Combine the dry ingredients with the butter and egg mixture, and at last, shredded carrots. Sad looking batter, but tastes good. And pour the batter in 2 baking pans that's been buttered and floured. Bake it in a preheated oven at 350 Fahrenheit for approximately 35 minutes. The classic topping for carrot cake is cream cheese frosting, which I love to make using homemade Greek yogurt. You just have to be sure to strain the liquid to give it a smooth, silky texture you want. This will be tangier, but in my opinion, better than store-bought cream cheese. Let this hang in the cotton fabric for a few hours, making sure it doesn't touch the bottom of the pan. But keep it in your fridge. After 3 hours, you're gonna have your thick cream cheese to make your frosting. Then you can mix it with butter, lemon zest, vanilla extract, and confectioner's sugar. Mix it until it's smooth and silky, and when you look at it, you realize you can't help yourself but to eat it.
I listen to my words, but they fall far below. I let my music take me where my heart wants to go.
The cake is ready, and so is the frosting. Now all we need is to layer them together. Using a serrated knife, cut the cakes in half symmetrically. I'm not that great doing it, but this is good enough. Spread a layer of frosting and top it with the other half of the cake. Repeat the process, overlook the floss, and finish the cake with carrots. So uneven, it doesn't matter because the carrots will make them shine through. An organic garden right here, right now, ready to be eaten.
Women never really faint, and that villains always blink their eyes. Ooh. And that, you know, children are the only ones.
I can't wait to see what Andrew thinks about my cake with his carrots. That's the perfect match.
Are you ready to see what I turn your carrots into?
I'm extremely excited.
Okay, cool. This is a American style carrot cake. I used your rainbow carrots, all of them right here. You get to see the specks of colors. Let's dig into it. All right, let's do it.
All right.
All right, cool. It's a tall cake. It barely fits in the fork.
That's amazing. Oh, wow. That's incredible.
It's perfect, isn't it?
And the icing's not overwhelming. I like the cream cheese.
How much would you pay for this?
That's a $30 cake. Easily.
Brazilian carrot cake is quite different from American carrot cake. We blend the carrots in the batter and we have a chocolate frosting, never cream cheese frosting.
Really?
Yeah. If they see this, they wouldn't recognize it as a carrot cake.
No kidding.
Why do you think people should consume more local foods?
One is you get a much better product. It's a lot fresher. It's better for you. Second is that you can actually have an opportunity to know your farmer, where it's coming from. I mean, the person's integrity is really a large part of it. You can only have certifications up to a point, and then you're trusting somebody so that they can source directly from us, as opposed to going through wholesalers, which then increases the price for them, and then as a result to the consumer.
And to you.
Yeah, exactly. So it gets more difficult, and so direct sales are kind of the way I think that...
So then you can never buy a $30 cake.
That's right, then you can never buy a $30 cake. Welcome back anytime, especially with food like this.
I brought something to you. I believe you don't plant here, but I might be wrong. I brought you lemons.
That's awesome.
Do you have lemons here?
No, not at this ranch. It gets a little too cold up in this area for citrus.
Yeah, I think I picked some green ones for you, but yeah, I just brought from the last farm I visited. And I want to take your photograph. Keep for myself forever. You're a cool dude. Cute. Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You're lovely.
Thanks for coming by.
Thank you for talking to me.
Yeah, absolutely.
You don't need to travel to distant lands or spend a fortune on imported products to be daring and diversify your palate. Many leaves and flowers that surround us are actually edible. Unfortunately, most people don't know this and continue to eat no more than the same 15 vegetables their entire lives. May the diversity on our plates reflect the diversity we embrace in our hearts. And if you don't embrace that, start embracing it. We should all embrace it. Pretty sure I'll be dreaming about rainbows tonight.